Next up from Los Angeles, California, we have the Hamilton Academy of Music Combo 1.
We're happy to be back, and today we'll be playing the same set, Champs in the Hollywood Shop. And Keelan, Ellis, I'm Franklin, this is Anthony. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you. Why don't you try a little bit of the band in the last two? Come down a notch. With vowel things, it's easier to compromise. So it means a little less than you.
I think it's really high quality, but I think you guys can do another tune. Right? That's kind of what I was hoping to hear something new. You're all seniors, you're all great players. You gotta like push yourself. So, was it memorized last time though? Was it? You had music. Okay. Yeah. I was gonna say I seem to remember that we talked about that. So that's good. Which we, right.
Well, I think from a program standpoint, what are we missing? Who's the one person who gets the solo? What would happen if we had a middle tune that was softer and slower or moody? How would that contrast? Because the two tunes were both birdie, but we kind of had the same sort of setup, you know, with the band trying to solo again. But what happened is after you got this beautiful timekeeper, by the way, very, very nice. But what happened if all of a sudden we just did a really hard shift on that middle tune?
Yeah.
You know, do you bow?
Yeah, it bows really well.
Wow, how about a really pretty tuned bow? What would that do in terms of really, really cultivating the musical stage?
Tell them that you didn't do a third tune because you wanted more time for a third.
Yeah, right. No, but I mean, that was my main comment because I heard you guys play great classics 2 weeks ago. I want to hear more. That's a good problem. The only other thing I saw heard about too is making decisions. It's mostly in the rhythm section, the musical, the drums. You know, every time we're playing, I remember this. I remember going to a clinic. One of my favorite bass players, Robert Herbst. You know who that is? He's one of my favorite. Anyone else know who Robert Herbst is? I'm all alone. Okay, that's cool. Do you know who Robert Herbst is?
Oh.
He was Wynton Marsalis' bass player, like way back when Chris was down. But he said this thing and it stuck with me for so many years. And he said, as I'm playing as a rhythm section player, and it really said, am I being cool? Am I being a drag? And I'm not saying either of you are being a drag, but that's the decision you're making. Well, am I playing too loud? That would be a drag. Am I playing decisions that are taking away from the overall force of the feel, right? The groove. And there were a few times where I walked looking at the paper, like, what was that? Oh, okay. And just moments like that. And it was just in fills. You have to be real careful that you don't fill to the point where it actually upsets the groove. Right. Like I said, it only happened a few times, so it's just be conscious of it. As it for all of us.
If you try to coax some more orchestration possibly out of the small group, you can't add more. You can't subtract more.
Yeah.
first parts of the solo, lay out the entire first verse.
Right.
Here it is. All right, here we go. I'll second some.
Thank you.
to say that's great, and you know, I walk into the concert. At the beginning of your solo, I'd love you to, can we try rap playing just the three of you? And then two bars empty space, so you play for two bars and you can't play anymore. Try that, just real fast.
Try.
One, two, three. Now, play for two, then leave two empty. You have great lines, but just go right in and you never stop. So just forcing yourself to take away, you know, would help too. Especially when you're building, like Tom did, where you guys like had this real peak to where you're going, you can just start lower, right?
And you know what you can do in those bars of rest? Take a big breath.
Yeah, right. And isn't that cool too? Because that kind of gives you some space to, you know.
It's a wonderful group. Go right.